estate has the maximum value of M before it's killed by the next action of the operator. The maximum value of M is 4L. L equals the maximum value of M for that particular collection of states. Minus L is, of course, the minimum value. And so the values of M go from minus L to plus L. And then nothing beyond that from above, nothing beyond it from below. How many states is that all together? And you go from minus L to plus L. 2L plus 1. So a multiplet, a collection of states, is characterized with which, and a given value of, but a collection of states of this type, a multiple, has typically 2L plus 1 states. 2L plus 1 states. That's the first thing we find. Could have it from the other. Sure, that's just L equals infinity. Thank you. It is a possibility, but it's not one that we're going to worry about. They're pathological. The reason they're pathological, for a variety of reasons, a lot of reasons that they're pathological, but among other things, energy usually depends on the angular momentum. As you increase the angular momentum, keeping other things fixed, the energy goes up. And if you're interested in states of finite energy, then you're not interested in states with infinite angular momentum. Okay. Let's do one more little exercise. What characterizes these multiplets? Well, I'll tell you what characterizes these multiplets. It's the magnitude of the angular momentum. All of the states in this 2L plus 1 collection have the same value of the magnitude of the angular momentum. Now, what do we mean by the magnitude of the angular momentum? What we mean by the magnitude of the angular momentum is exactly what you would mean in classical physics. Square of the magnitude of the angular momentum. It's the magnitude of the angular momentum vector squared. And that's equal to Lx squared plus Ly squared plus Lz squared. The only difference between classical physics and quantum physics, these are now operators. They're not just numbers in a sense, they're quantum mechanical operators. And let's see what we can find out about L squared. In particular, L squared for a multiplet of 2L plus 1 states. In other words, supposing we have a multiplet which terminates from above at L, terminates from below at minus L, what can we say about its L squared? So, here's the tricks. And they're all tricks, but they're nice tricks. This is equal to Lz squared. Now, first classical. Lx squared plus Ly squared plus Lx plus Ily. Do I want Lx minus Ily? Times Lx plus Ily. This is Lx squared plus Ly squared and the cross term 0 classically. So this is a correct equation classically. It's not quite right quantum mechanically, and the reason is that Lx and Ly don't compute. We actually have an extra term here. We have the extra term, let's see what it is. It's I, Lx, Ly, this product, and then minus I, Ly, Lx. So it has the commutator of Lx, Ly, the commutator of Lx, Ly. other words, overshot by writing in LX minus RLY to LX plus RLY. Subtract this minus R. That's just the extra piece that's there, because LX times LY is not equal to LY times LX. Okay, so that's straightforward. But what is the commutator of LX with LY? LX with LY is ILZ. So, this is equal to LZ squared. Now, we're going to get I from the LZ. There's an I here, and then there's another I from the commutator. I times minus I is plus 1. So this will be plus LZ. LZ squared plus LZ. And then we have plus L minus times L plus. Okay, remember. That's L squared. Square of the angle. Now let's apply that. Let's take this operator and apply it to the maximum highest M state. M equals L. M equals L. So let's take this L squared on L. L is the highest thing. What do we get? We get LZ squared on L plus LZ times L plus L minus L plus. First of all, what is this description? It's an eigenvector. Remember what it stands for. It stands for the eigenvector of LZ with the highest possible value in this multiplet. What is LZ? LZ is equal to little L. State up here, LZ is equal to little L. Let's go back. So many letters. Sorry, so many letters, but that's just the way it is. LZ, or the state M, was defined to be an eigenvector of LZ. That's what it says. In particular, the top eigenvector here is a substitute for M, substitute L. So here we have it. LZ on L is just the numerical number L on L. What about LZ squared? That's just L squared. You're just hitting it with the operator LZ twice. The first time you hit it, it gives you an L. The second time you hit it, it gives you another L. So that's L squared. Okay, that was easy. But what about this here, guys? What are we going to do about here? The zero. Why? Because L plus, when it hits the top, runs out of space. That was the definition of the top here. The definition of the top state is if L plus is zero. So, we can just erase this. And now we've learned something. That this state L is an eigenvector of the square of the angular momentum. Let's write the square of the square now. L squared plus L times L. Or better yet, L times L plus 1.